Structure. So the structure is that we have a P meridian, an N meridian, a P meridian again. So we have a P meridian, an N meridian, and a P meridian. So we have one leg, the other leg. So this is a P, N, P meridians. And then we shall have the middle meridian being our base. So we got this one as the base, as the collector, and this is as the mirror. So this is the structure. So now we need to have, these are two diodes. There's a PN diode, and then there's an NP diode. So where do you think these diodes are facing? So here we have diode equivalent. So according to this kind of arrangement we got before, or from this one, where is this first pair? Where is the diode being facing? So we would have this direction, because we talk about current being transferred by the holes, and that means holes would be moving from the P meridian where there are many and going towards the N meridian where. So then we would have the other part. So this one also would be facing this direction. So here in the middle is where we have our base. We have our emitter, we have our collector. So for the circuit symbol, let me take them as symbols. There are two symbols. The flat surface which you saw on the diode of the transistor in the lab, the transistor was a bit semicircular with the one part, and then you had legs emerging from these parts. The flat part, this flat part here, is this same flat part. And that's how we show our transistor. So I'll start with this, draw it to this side, put this one up. Some of you were drawing them even with curves. When you were drawing the diagrams, I saw some of you drawing and doing like this. Starting from the next experiments, I'll be doing that if you do that. So, because being that they are made of diodes, it means if you are to have a current flowing in this transistor, the current will go from the emitter, you know, the base. Otherwise, you wouldn't have anything coming from the base this side, because there is no conduction to a diode in the opposite direction. So that's why you see in some books, in most books, you have an arrow there with your base, collector, mirror. Does it now make sense of the symbols you were seeing in the stable multivibrator in the experiment of 10, not 10, I think 5, 7, and D14 and T14, I guess. So these are two symbols. You can draw it this way, or you can actually have a circle on the segment of the circle, on one part of the segment of the circle around here. You put your flat part. This is to show that flatness on the transistor. Those of you who have blown it or use it. I know there's a group which blew it, but the one you blew, it had that flat thing. So then we put our, which meets the circle, goes down, meets the circle, goes up to the collector, the mirror, and then the base. And then the arrow goes inside. So the arrow is not a guesswork. The arrow is because of which type of transistor are you dealing with? Is it a PNP, meridians arranged together, of NPN materials arranged together. So now we look at NPN. NPN transistor. I do the same stuff. Draw the structure. That equivalent. Symbols. We will be having our three materials. Just divide your tongue into three so that you have the mirror, you have the base, you have the collector, and then you have now this being an N, a P, and an M material. And then you transit to the diode equivalent. The diode will be facing this way, this one will be facing this way. So we will have our diodes in this form, the collector, the other diode facing this direction, to the emitter, and this one going to the base. The circuit symbol. One symbol will be simply that to the collector, to the emitter, to the base, and the arrow now will be from the base towards the emitter because the current will be able to flow outward due to the arrangement that is making up our diode, which is from P to N, that's where the current will flow. Since it is constituted by the flow of holes. And then drawing this other side, see how I draw it nicely? The thing is not in the middle because even when you look at the real transistor, the flatness is not in the middle. It's not the same sample. It's somehow towards the end. And then we'll have our base. We have our arrow pointing up to the circular barrier, to the emitter, and then we have the collector.